Well, if you want to sing out, sing out. And if you want to be free, be free. 'Cause there's a million things to be. You know that there are.
Before I get started, how many people here like food? Just, we might want to think about the food pyramid as a size 7 shoe. So if you are able to wear a size 7 shoe, you're good. No food sensitivities, you can eat your grains, your meat, your dairy, your eggs, you're good to go. But for everyone else, we need to know our size. We need to know what nourishes us, and we need to make this not only a change in how we view food, which I think we are at now with all of the different organizations leading the charge, but also think about reversing this pyramid into a circle.
I never bake anything, so I'm not quite sure why I'm here. I do, however, I am a huge fan of organic, and in Boulder we do take that for granted a little bit, but most of the world and most of America's school children are eating food plus chemicals, and that food is obviously heavily processed. So I find this event, you know, personally very inspiring.
What are the statistics? Why all of a sudden do we see all these kids with food allergies? And as I turned to the numbers, which is what I was comfortable doing, I learned that there had been a 265% increase in the rate of hospitalizations related to food allergic reactions in the last few years from the CDC. I learned that there had been a doubling of the peanut allergy from 1997 until 2002. And that at that point, 5 years ago, 1 out of 17 kids under the age of 3 had a food allergy. And I looked at that data and those statistics and I thought, what's changed? Because I didn't know anybody that had food allergies when I was a kid. And as I learned, a food allergy is when your body sees food as foreign and launches an inflammatory response to try to drive out that foreign invader. And so I asked the question, I said, is there something foreign in our food? In 1994, in order to enhance profitability for the food industry, we began to engineer foreign proteins into our food supply. The very first one was done to the dairy supply. It was a synthetic growth hormone that was injected into cows to help them make more milk. Soy was the next example. With the engineering of soy in 1996, in order to make it withstand increasing doses of Monsanto's weed killer, it had been patented, but again, not accepted around the world because those human studies had never been done. And yet at the same time, there had been a doubling of the soy allergy when that was introduced in the U.S.
The School Food Project, if you don't know, is nutrition services at Boulder Valley School District. Last year, we came into the district, 48 schools, and the first thing we did was put a salad bar in every school. So all of our students have access to a salad bar with fresh fruits and vegetables, as much as they can eat every day of the school week, every day of the school year.
Where everything, not just the country of origin, I want to know the farm of origin. I want to know the factory of origin.